flies, and this video is gonna be my Halloween recommendations to give you Halloween vibes. So I know it's the end of the month already, and if I was gonna do a recommendation video, I probably should have done that earlier in the month, but I kind of had my mindset on doing this video, so I just figured this is another video that I would have up this month. At least you would have some ideas for next year for Halloween, which you don't have to wait for October to read spooky books. So if you want, you can still take my recommendations, and at least next year you'll know what types of books to look for to give you those vibes that you like, because some people don't necessarily like scary, some people just like a little mild creepiness, or just give you that mild paranoia feeling. Everybody doesn't want to be scared shitless, and I understand that, but I'm one of those people that doesn't mind being scared shitless in a book. But there's recommendations for both sides. So first, I would like to do a couple graphic novels that I have that I know would be great for Halloween. Because sometimes you might not want to read like a full like novel Halloween wise. You might just want something quick like a graphic novel you can read in like 30 minutes an hour, and you know, be kind of done with it. But it'll give you, you know, get you in the Halloween feeling. I don't know why I'm doing all of this for this video. Okay, so the first thing that I have, and I recommend this every year since I think 2015 when I read it for the first time. This is like my first official graphic novel that I ever read, but that is Witches by Scott Snyder. I recommend this graphic novel every freaking year. It never fails. I will always recommend this because I feel like this is a perfectly creepy, scary, Halloween-y book. Like, it's not about witches, okay? It's called Witches, but it's not your typical witch. Okay, so don't think, oh, I don't want to, this is really cliche, I don't want to read about a witch. It's not. It's fucking awesome. The graphics in here are amazing. The plot was really good. It was like watching a horror movie in action. It was just the graphics. And at the end, you know, he has the interviews that he's done, pictures that he, that through the process of, you know, his graphics evolving, and some pictures that didn't make it in, you know, it's just the graphics in here were amazing, people. Like, the graphics really were something to blush about. They were really great. So that's the first graphic novel that I have. The next graphic novel that I have that I want to recommend is Through the Woods by Emily Carroll, and I read this on Overdrive or Hoopla. It was an ebook that I had. No. You know what? I checked it out from the library. That's what it was. It was a library book that I checked out, so I don't have it with me, but I recommend that one as well. It has different levels of creepy. I think it has 5 different stories in that graphic novel, and it's all different levels of creepy. My favorite one is The Woman with Cold Hands. I think that one is the scariest, and that one is like the best. Like, it's scary, but it's not scary enough to kill you, you know? So, but it's really gross and it's creepy, and I love it so fucking much. But there are some that are really mild that are just like, you know, whatever. But I think it's a good collection as a whole because it has those different ranges of it was really mild, and now we're up to the hot stuff, you know, and Diablo and all of that, you know. I love that it had those different flavors and those different settings, and it wasn't just all one tune. So I think that one was really good. And then I would love to recommend American Vampire by Scott Snyder. I read this one at the beginning of this year, and I read it on Hoopla. So download Hoopla and check out the graphic novels. This is on there. Hoopla is completely free through your library. If your library does all you need is a library card, and it's completely free, you don't have to pay a dime. You can check up to 8 titles out every month, and they automatically check back in, or you can check them back in yourself. It's up to you. But it's awesome. Okay, now that I'm done advertising for Hoopla, American Vampire by Scott Snyder is awesome. I'm reading the second volume probably tomorrow-ish while I'm filming this. Okay, so once I upload it, I should have been read it already. But the first volume he did in partner with Stephen King, and I loved it. It was amazing. Like, talk about making a vampire comeback. Yes, I loved this. This reignited my flame for vampires, reading that graphic novel. So if you into graphic novels, but you kind of been over, if you was like me, I have been kind of on like a vampire hangover since Twilight, and I just haven't been feeling the vampire-ness since Twilight. This one does you really well. Okay, so check it out. It's really great. And then the last graphic novel that I have that I want to recommend is for you ones out there that aren't really into creepy, like scary. You want that mild, you know, you wet your pants easy. It's Anya's Ghost. Can't think of the author's name. But it wasn't creepy. I think I gave this 3 stars. Like, it wasn't scary. It was very mild. I don't know if it's middle grade. I think it's a middle grade horror graphic novel. Because it was very mild on the scary. Like, it follows this ghost that's losing her shit. But, you know, it was very mild. But it's good for y'all that doesn't care for the scary stuff. In case, you know, that might be something you're into. And it was kind of cutesy, too. The graphics were right. They were, like, average. They weren't anything. They were over the top. But they didn't suck. So, getting into some novels, the first two that I'm going to recommend are from the same author. They're by Richard Denny, and it's What Lies Beneath and The Library of Souls, which he has a second one coming out at the end of the month, in November, at the end of the month, one of those. It's the second book for The Library of Souls, but his is middle grade horror novel, and what I love about Library of Souls is it has like the creepy pictures in it. But both novels are middle grade, both novels are creepy. Library of Souls is a little bit milder than What Lies Beneath. What Lies Beneath has a pretty fast-paced plot, not too fast, but just that perfect speed in the plot. There are moments in his books where it's very scary. I don't want to say, nothing that's like, God, how do I explain this? It's not where you'll be scared to go to sleep at night, but it may give you dreams. It might give you dreams. So I wasn't expecting to be, you know, for it to be like that because it was a middle grade novel. So I wasn't expecting to be like thinking about having nightmares, but boy was I paranoid to go to sleep. I'm not even gonna lie to you. And I told him that. So his novels are really, really good. It really depends on what you want. And the covers tell all. So if you want more mild, do Library of Souls. But if you wanted just to take it up a notch, do What Lies Beneath. The next book that I have is Bad Girl Gone by Temple Matthews that I have somewhere on my shelf. I just can't find it and I thought I took it down and I guess I didn't, but it's somewhere up here. But it follows a ghost. Okay, she when it starts, she doesn't know she's a ghost. She doesn't know, she can't remember what happened to her. And it's like an orphanage for the ghosts that are trying to figure out what happened before they pass on. And that's where she starts to figure out, and she gets this group of ghost friends that starts to their job is to help each other figure out what happened to them and how did they die. And ghost justice, they get their own justice for their deaths. This one was really great. It's really not scary at all, but it was very enjoyable. And it gives you Halloween vibes because it's ghosts and it's spirits and it's just... Oh God, it was amazing. I loved it. I want to say I gave it 4 stars, but it was really good. I really enjoyed it. I would recommend it to everybody. So even if you're a scaredy cat, this book is like perfect. It's not horrifying. It's like, at some points it's really heartbreaking though sometimes. Cause it's like, oh my God, that's really sad. Especially when you see these kids that have died and it's like all kids that have been murdered. It's not just of normal causes. So it's like, sometimes it's really heartbreaking and then sometimes you're laughing and smiling and then sometimes you're angry with them and it's just, I love this book. So I recommend this one to everybody, but since it's ghost related, it gives you Halloween. Then the next one I have, which is also one I kind of recommend every year, and that's Tales from the Graveyard by Suzanne Schultz. I read this one, I got this one from NetGalley a couple years ago around the time I first started BookTube. And I loved it. Like, I loved it as a collection as a whole. I think I gave it 4 stars as a whole. But I think it's four or five different short stories, all like, but they all like kind of combine with one another. And they're very gross. Like, they're grossly horrific. So I would say this is at like a moderate level. It's not scary. Like, it'll make you paranoid. but it's gross. Like, it's one of those like horror novels that are like really gross. Like, it's just a lot of blood splatter and guts, and it's just, it's disgusting. So I'm gonna give it moderate to mild to moderate in that area for recommending that. Then I always recommend this as well, and that's any of the Goosebumps books for Halloween for you mild readers that aren't into, that's not trying to be scared, because Goosebumps is not really scary at all. Like, it's really not scary at all. Like, it's just kind of weird stories, but it's not anything that makes you scared. So I always recommend Goosebumps to those of you that doesn't want to be scared, but you want the Halloween vibes, you want the creepy setting, but you don't want to be scared. This is perfect. You could read this and then go right to sleep after and dream about unicorns. Like, Goosebumps isn't crazy at all. And I have two of them. Technically, they're not mine, but I'm probably going to read at least one of them because I haven't read Goosebumps in a while. Technically, they are for my husband, but what's his is mine, it was mine is his. So technically, they're mine too. And I have The Ghost Next Door and Why I'm Afraid of Bees. So, and this one is Why I'm Afraid of Bees. That doesn't really sound, I never read this one. It doesn't sound horrifying at all. I haven't read all the Goosebumps books. That would be a wonderful adventure to buy the box sets of the Goosebumps and like actually like read all of them. That would be a wonderful adventure. I don't know which one I'm gonna read though. I think I'm gonna read The Ghost Next Door. But they're under 200 pages. I think this one's 124 pages. Yeah, this one's Ghost Next Door is only 124 pages. And I think Why I'm Afraid of Bees is only 174 pages, if I'm correct. No, 117 pages. They're all under 200 pages, which is something you could probably read in one sitting one day. So it's not something that's going to take up too much of your time. It's a quick read, almost as if you're reading a graphic novel. So it's quick and it's light, very mild, below mild, scary, but it gets you in the Halloween mood. And the last book that I want to recommend, and I have not been on my job this year, I usually do this every year in October. I recommend Edgar Allan Poe. I have the complete tales and poems, so I would read like one poem or one story every day throughout October. And I really have not been on my job this year. I haven't read one story or one poem this year. But as y'all know, Edgar Allan Poe is like this creepy, what's the word I'm looking for? Disturbed author. So it's like all of his poems are horrific. They don't end up good. They always end up bad. And I just would recommend just reading one poem or one story a day. Or, you know, not even a day, a week if you want to. But, you know, it gets you in the Halloween mood. He's a twisted mind. All of them, none of them, I don't think have happy endings. So it's like perfect for Halloween, okay? It makes you think though. His stuff really makes you think. And it makes you, it creeps you out. But it doesn't scare you. Like, you know, like it doesn't scare you, but it definitely creeps you out and makes you think of like otherworldly things and what's in the shadows and what's the intentions behind people. He's perfect. Like, he's perfect for Halloween if you don't read anything else. And I got this when I first started BookTube. I think I had this right before I started BookTube, and I've been on BookTube for 3 years. And I want to say I got this off of Amazon, but the one I seen in Barnes & Noble, they had like the gold pages, and I really, really wanted that edition, but Barnes & Noble is expensive. I can't remember how much I paid for it, but I think this is a good investment to get bound up like this. Great investment. So people, I hope I gave you some Halloween vibes in this video. Okay, I hope I gave it to you. Okay, and that's all I have for my video. If you have any other recommendations that you would like to recommend for me, I love scary, horror, thriller, whatever you want to call it. I love creepy books. I love stuff like that. So I don't really have a gauge. It can be mild or it can be over the top, scare me out of my drawers scary. I would love to see any recommendations that y'all might have for me to read. And I will let y'all know how it goes. You know, I would just give me a recommendation. Throw one out there, you know, and I could see, you know, if I like it or not, and we can have a conversation about it. But yeah, that's all I have. Don't forget to like, share, and subscribe, and I will see y'all next time. Bye.